In this video, I'm going to show you Scrivener Scratchpad and its one main advantage over other note-taking functions. Here we go. Hi, this is Bela from the Writer's Territory, and today I'm going to show you how Scrivener Scratchpad works and how it can help your brainstorming or note-taking process. You open the Scratchpad by going to Window, Show Scratchpad. I gotta say, when I first saw this, I thought, what the heck do I need this for? I already have document notes and project notes, so why would I need another notepad? And then I discovered the one important difference between the Scratchpad and other note-taking functions in Scrivener. Which is, the Scratchpad is completely independent from any Scrivener project. This means every note that you keep in the Scratchpad is stored inside the Scratchpad and not in a specific Scrivener project. And this gives you a lot of freedom. Let's say you come up with any idea or any thought or anything that you want to scribble down real quick, and you're not yet sure what you're going to do with this thought or where it's going to belong, and you just want to get it out of your system and keep it in a safe place. That's exactly what the Scratchpad is for. Just fire it up and put your notes in there. To add or delete notes, use these two buttons here in the lower left corner. As soon as you've decided what you're going to do with your thoughts, or at least to which Scrivener project you want to transfer them, click down here and then you see the projects that are open right now. Choose if you want to append the note to an already existing document or import it as a subdocument of a specific document in the binder, like this. And there it is, and now it's its own document inside this Scrivener project. If you want to specify where your Scratchpad notes are stored on your hard drive, go to Preferences and in the General tab, choose the Scratchpad location. You can also select in which format you want your Scratchpad notes to be saved, rich text with attachments, rich text or plain text. And you can define a keyboard shortcut so that you can fire it up even quicker. That's it. If you like this video and you're here for the first time, please subscribe to my channel. I want to help you find the perfect writing software for you and help you with problems and questions you might have about the software you already own, so you can go back to your writing as quickly as possible and spread the important stories and messages you want to share with others and hopefully enrich other people's lives. If you want to get in contact with me, the links are down below. Just drop me a message and I'll respond as quickly as I can. Have fun writing, everybody. See you. Bye.